What are you gonna do?
I told you. We're gonna hang out. We're gonna watch a movie. We're gonna take some pictures. And I'll pay you.
Have you ever wanted to feel happy? Yeah, me too, bud. I'm gonna tell you straight up, that's not what this game's about. Not at all. If someone asked me to describe Deepwoken in my own words, personally, I would have to say pain, despair, and misery. Now you might be asking yourself, Sam, it's a Roblox game. It's just a silly little Roblox game. How could it ever invoke such emotions in you? Well, let me tell you a little something. Alright, this game has without a doubt caused me the most intense and long-lasting grief I've ever experienced in my life. While this one on its own is extraordinary for a game, I'd like to also say that it's made me reach heights of ecstasy never seen before. With that being said, let me tell you a little bit more about this game. So, out of the interest of both of us, me and you, the viewer, I'm going to try and make this part as fast as possible because this is hands down the most boring part. But basically, Deepwoken was made by Monad Studios on December 20th, 2021, and it's a $5 game. It has complex lore that I wouldn't even dare going into in just one video alone, or at least in this video as well. It'd be way too long, I think. It features many different weapons, and it has three main archetypes for those weapons, with that being heavy, light, and medium. There's six different magic types, with that being ice, fire, wind, lightning, and basically metal bending's the last one. And there's two different maps you can go onto, and that doesn't sound like a lot, but these maps are huge. Each map is basically its own world. And these maps include bosses. Some of them have their own dungeons. I think it might only be one, and that's Duke. But hey, he still has his own dungeon. And they each have their own rewards for doing it and killing those bosses. But what really brings me into the game is the mechanics. So the mechanics of this game are quite unique. Or not unique for the type of game it is, but unique for a Roblox game, I would like to think. And so basically this game features permadeath, and it's not the permadeath people think of whenever you say permadeath. It's like permadeath light. You get three lives and then your character's completely gone. But it's not always three lives. It's really two lives, then you have a chance of redemption. So it's not all that bad if you're not into the hardcore gaming category. Whenever you start the game, you're also given multiple places you can start from, each of them having their own benefits and locations. The benefits of them, starting off, it's literally just how close you are to your next level up, how close you are to enemies and stuff like that. But whenever you get a little bit further in the game, you unlock more origins. It does have a significant impact on your game. It can change the entire play style of your game. This game also features oaths and bells, and oaths and bells are just ways of spicing up your build. You can only ever take one oath in the entire build, or your entire life of that character, unless it's oathless. And basically what these oaths do is give you access to more mantras, and then also its own special abilities, which is honestly pretty sick to me. Next up is bells. Bells are one of the hands down coolest features of this game. It's basically an in-game ability that you have to grind to unlock, and every bell except smokescreen has its uses. You could always make a bell work with your build, no matter what. And even if you can't, you can grind idols of Yuntrul from bosses, which is an item that drops from bosses. And you use that, and you can reroll your bell as many times as you want, which is very useful. Another major part of this game that makes it unique is the fact that no two builds will ever be completely alike. Okay, that's a little bit of an exaggeration, but it's very hard to get that way because whenever you level up, you get random cards, and those cards are based off of what points you've put into your attributes. But because of this, that adds a little bit of randomness to your builds, and it might make your builds worse than the last one or better than the last one. There's really no telling until the build's over with. Another great thing about this game is, well, I wouldn't say great. Another thing about this game is its community. Its community can either be literally angels on earth saving you from wiping your character in the depths and dropping you in chance and helping you out through your day to literally just wiping your account over and over and over again in depths just because some of your clan members are dickheads and they want to take it out on you instead of the clan members. Which, I mean, understandable. I do the same shit. Can't really, like, get mad at them for that. But come on, man. Never happens to me. It's not cool. On the topic of little shitters in the community, there's two specific types of people who are just absolute fucking assholes. Okay, these are Void Walkers, which, you know, game is game. It's one of the hardest origins to pick, so if you want to kill me, go for it. I don't really give a shit. You earned it. Whatever, dude. Unless you're, like, jumping me or some shit. But, the other ones are people you can find in the depths. So you usually find these people whenever you're doing, the depths origin. And it makes you start in the depths, which is where you go on your last life. And it's where you decide if you keep your character or if it dies and wipes forever. But in this origin, you start in the depths and you have to progress there. So you essentially only have one life. Okay, so while you're down there, the main tactic is to be bigger numbers than the mobs you have to kill, which is easier said than done, but that's besides the point. While you're down there and you do get in a group of people, you can find a high level character to carry you throughout killing mobs and leveling up. But let's just say you're down there and you meet a specific type of person. Okay, I would describe them as scum of the earth. Okay, there's a type of person down in the depths that whenever you hit them by accident, and it's very obvious it's an accident, they will, like the cringe lord they are, slowly approach you and put their fat fingers on their keyboard and type, "Say my bad or else." Now, I'm a generational hater. I love hate of all forms. All kinds of hate. I don't discriminate. But this is too far, man. I've been killed way too many times to justify this kind of hatred. This goes beyond hatred. It's at the point where it's not even hatred. It's, you're taking your anger out of your previous deepwoken lives out on me. And I think that is fucking sad, okay? Get a life, man. I just wanna have fun playing deepwoken, do my depths bound character. Leave me alone. Stop saying my bad, say my bad, all right? Fucking assholes. now that I'm off that rant, let's go on to replayability. The replayability of this game is honestly phenomenal. It's a roguelike, so, you know, you get to just redo your builds over and over and over and over until you get the god build. And as I mentioned before, a good portion of this game is just luck. So your builds are not going to be the same, and that adds into the roguelike that makes every build different and makes it actually fun. And every build just has a little bit more spice than the last one, because you always find something new that can make your build better. They've added Chime of Conflict. Well, I say added like it's been recent, but they've added it for a while. But now they have their own dedicated PvP, and they've sort of taken away people who just gank for no reason. I love that. I love it so much. They've also made it so you don't have to do 1v1s anymore. You can do 1v1s, 2v2s, 3v3s, which is honestly a great thing, a great feature. Now on to the less great features. With every goated pog sauce game, I'm sorry, I shouldn't have said that. Fuck. With every good game, there's a few things that you have to overlook. But what if those things are almost unoverlookable? I don't even know if that's a word. I don't know. I'll have to check that later. Basically, you can spend hours on a build. It's not bad whenever you spend an hour, maybe a couple minutes on a build and you get wiped through some dumb shit. You get like PvP'd one way or another and you die, you wipe, it's whatever. But you spend hours on a build. You build an emotional connection with this build. This is your child, okay? And then Mr. Monad Studios decides, hey man, I'm gonna spawn 7 Sharkos around you. And I'm gonna watch you as you have to sit there and watch me rip your child from your arms, and I'm gonna laugh in your face about it while you're crying. My point is, every time you die on a big boy character, it's honestly heartbreak. It sucks so bad, but that's really the name of the game whenever you're signing up for a hardcore game. You know, that's not really one of my bigger complaints. I just wanted to point that out so, you know, you're not putting down the $5 to buy this game and disappointed. But another thing is the fucking skill gap, okay? It takes a lot of information about this game to get to a point where you can make builds over and over again successfully without just wiping. You should be comfortable with losing characters whenever you're playing your first hours in the game. I would say your first days in the game, honestly. You should be okay with just losing your character. There's no point in getting attached to them. They're gone until you learn, like, how to parry, dodge, block. Now, hands down, the worst feature about this game, and I have many friends. You could probably get every Deepwoken player to attest to this, but they have horrible servers. I mean, the worst servers you could ever imagine. If you could imagine someone unplugging your Ethernet cable in the middle of you downloading something and then looking at your download speed on Steam, that is not even a percent how bad Deepwoken servers are, okay? You can lose characters just from the lag alone. It's easier to find a server that you're lagging on than to find one you're not lagging on. You know what I mean? Like, it's just horrible. You can never find a good server. And when you do, it's always whenever you're about to leave. Always. It's like it's planned. Fuck. I'm still not good at conclusions, guys. I'll be honest. Honestly, I like the game. I'm gonna keep playing it. Actually, I quite enjoy it. I'm not gonna lie. It's just the lag, man. Come on. Throw me a bone. But other than the lag, I'd say it's a 9. 9 out of 10. But with the lag included, it'd have to be like a fucking average 5. Even, let's go with a variable 3 if I wipe. I really don't know what that rating means. Take that as you want. Buy the game, don't. It's $5. If you like the video, like and subscribe. It doesn't take long. I'd really appreciate it. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.